Good morning everyone. Welcome to Narayana Live Classes. Today we are going to discuss assignment number 1 based on surface areas and volumes. So let us look after the question number 1. A tent of height 3.3 meters is in the form of a right circular cylinder of diameter 12 meters and height 2.2 meters surmounted by a right circular core of same diameter. So here first let us draw the figure for this, then it will be clear for us. See here, the question is a tent of height 3.3 meters is in the form of a right circular cylinder. Okay, so now here we are having a tent. It is in the form of a right circular cylinder surmounted by a cone. Okay, so right circular cylinder surmounted by a cone. So this is the cylindrical part what we have here, and on this we are having a cone. This is the conical part. So here, if you see this, total height of the tent is 3.3 meters. So complete is 3.3 meters. So complete is 3.3 meters. And diameter of this complete part is see here. This is the cylindrical part. So this is 12 meters. So if it is 12 meters, so radius will be 6. Okay. So this complete is 12 meters. Okay, right. Now, in this, the cylindrical part height, if you see here, it is 2.2 meters. That means, this up to here, the cylindrical part is 2.2 meters. So, if this is 2.2 meters, then what about the conical part? This height, conical part complete is 3.2, this is 2.2. So, obviously, this conical part will be 1.1 meters. That means, the height of the cone is 1.1, right? Now what we have to do here, find the cost of canvas of tent at the rate of rupees 500 per square meter. That means I have to find out the complete surface area, okay, of this figure which is formed, this tent which is formed by the combination of cylinder as well as core. So what I am going to do right now, I have to find out the CSA of cylinder, CSA of core. I have to add both, okay, that will be giving you the surface area of this tent. For which I have to multiply with 500 per each. Okay, that means the square meters I am going to get, I will multiply with 500. So this is my complete question. So let us enter into the data for this, what is given for us particularly. Here we are having two figures. What are those? Cylinder and cone. So cylinder is the first one and the conical part is the next one. So whenever it is given for us, it is better if you write and keep it in this manner, it will be useful for us. Okay, so now here, height of the cylinder is 2.2 meters. Height here, it is 2.2 meters is the height in this case, surmounted by right circular cone. Okay, first let us look after the data of cylinder. So diameter is given for us 12 meters. Diameter is 12 meters. So obviously, radius will be 6 meters. Okay. Now CSA of cylinder 2 pi RH, we can find out the CSA here. Right. Now for the conical part, if you see, since the cone is placed on the cylinder, so obviously when it is placed on the cylinder, diameter of the cylinder will be exactly equal to the diameter of the cone. So here, diameter of the cone is also 12 meters. So if this is 12, obviously radius will be 6, right? Now here if you look after this, height of the cone, see as we told, complete height of the tent is 3.3 meters, out of which cylinder height is 2.2. So therefore, the conical part will be 1.1, okay? So height of the cone, height is 1.1, okay? Right? Here after this, getting this part of 1.1, we know slant height. See, why we are finding out slant height? See, the CSA of this cone is pi r, right? So we have to find out slant height. Slant height is equal to under root of r square plus h square, right? So here it is 6 square, that is 36. 36 plus 1.1 whole square is 1.21, right? So this is 37.21. 37.1 to square root of this is something like 6.1. So L also we got it as 6.1. Now what we will do here, we will find out CSA of cylinder with the help of 2 pi RH. we will find out cone CSA of cone with the help of pi r l. We will add them. From then, that will give me the surface area of the complete tent. That since the cost is at the rate of 500 rupees per square meter, the complete surface area I will multiply with 500 to get the complete cost. Right. So now, see here is what we have. CSA of cylinder 2 pi r h, that is 2 into 22 by 7 into 6 into 2.2, that is something like 580.8 by 7 square meters. Okay, this calculation part. CSA of cone pi r l 22 by 7 into 6 into 6.1, that is 805.2 by 7 square meters. Right, surface area of the tent is the calculation of both as we discussed. So addition of cylinder CSA and cone CSA, 580.8 by 7 square meters plus 805.2 by 7 square meters. So on adding them, I am going to get it as 1386 by 7, which is nothing but 198. So cost for 1 square meter is 500. Similarly, cost for 198 square meters will be 198 into 500, that will be giving you 99,000 rupees. Okay, this is the complete cost of canvas for the complete tent. Okay, now coming to the second question. So let us look after the second question here. A toy is in the form of a right circular cylinder with heavy sphere on one end and a cone on other end. Okay, first let us draw the figure for this, then we will have the calculation of this one. See, a toy is in the form of a right circular cylinder with heavy sphere on one end and a cone on other end. Okay, so see, this is the cylindrical part. On the cylindrical part, one side, one end we are having cone and other end we are having hemisphere. So let us take this as cone and here is the hemisphere structure. Now, so that means here we are coming across three parts, right? Hemisphere, cone and cylinder. Okay, now. So now hemisphere at one end and a cone at other end. So here it is hemisphere, cone and cylinder. These are the three things what we have in this. Okay, so now let us enter into the part. The height and the radius of base of the cylinder, cylindrical part are 13 centimeters and 5 centimeters. See, this is the base. Okay, so this is the complete diameter of the base here. Now, since cone and hemisphere are both on the cylinder, so obviously the diameter of the cylinder will be equal to the diameter of the cone as well as diameter of the hemisphere. Okay, so now here if you come across this part, first cylindrical case, it is the height and the radius of the base of the cylindrical part are 13 centimeters and 5 centimeters. This complete is 13, cylindrical part is 13 and here the base is, this is radius is 5 centimeters. That means when you see in the cylindrical part, it is 13 centimeters and radius is 5 centimeters. Okay, cylindrical part is clear. Now next, the radius of the hemisphere and base of the conical part are same as that of the cylinder. Okay, so hemisphere radius is also same. So that means radius of the hemisphere is nothing but again the same thing, that is 5 centimeters. Now, calculate the surface area of the toy if the height of the cone is 12 centimeters. So here, when you see this part, so this is the conical part what we have in this. In this, the height of the cone, what it is there exactly is given for you as 12 centimeters. So that means height of the cone is given for you as 12 centimeters. And since cone is placed on the cylinder, so obviously radius will be the same, that is r is equal to 5. We know this cylindrical part, since see here CSA of hemisphere is 2 pi r square, we can find out this, calculate directly. Cone is pi r l, so here I have to find out l in this case, it is nothing but under root of r square plus h square, that means 5 square is 25 plus 12 square is 144. So l is equal to 25 plus 144, that is equal to h square. So l is equal to 25 plus 144 will be giving you 169, that is equal to 13 centimeters. So we even got l here. So a cylinder part is h is known, r is known. We have the formula as 2 pi r h. Now what you have to find out? Calculate the surface area of the toy. To calculate the complete surface area of the toy, here I have three parts in this. One is cone, hemisphere, cone, cylinder. So what I will do? I will find out the CS of each one individually. Then finally I have to add them. This is the step what I am going to do in this. Right, so here for finding out CSA, we want the data which is given as per the question. We have separated them. Now here we see CSA of hemispherical part, 2 by r square, 2 into 22 by 7 into 5 into 5, that will be giving you 1100 by 7 square centimeters. So CSA of cylindrical part, that is 2 by r h, 2 into 22 by 7 into 5 into 13, that is 2860 by 7 square centimeters. CSA of cone, pi r l, that is 22 by 7 into 5 into 13, okay, is 1430 by 7 square centimeters. So TSA of the complete toy will be the sum of all the three CSA, that is the total surface area of the toy. The complete part will be the sum of the CSAs of all the three parts, that is 1100 by 7 square centimeters plus 2860 by 7 square centimeters plus 1430 by 7 square centimeters. So which will be giving you as 5390 by 7, that is equal to 770 centimeter square. Okay, this is the total surface area of the toy. So this completes the second question. Now coming to the question number 3. A medicine capsule is in the shape of cylinder with two hemispheres stuck to each of its ends. Okay, so here when you see this question right now, it is a capsule in the form of cylinder with two hemispheres. So let us take this one horizontally. So this is cylindrical part, and on this we are having two hemispheres on either ends. That means hemispheres on either ends of the cylinder. So now next one. Stuck to each of the length of the entire capsule is 14 mm. The complete is 14 mm. Right? And the diameter of the capsule is 5 mm. So here, this is the diameter of the capsule, that is 5 mm. Since the diameter is 5 mm, so here onwards, this will be the half of this. Okay? So radius will be 5 by 2 for the case of cylinder, okay na? And next part, so this is 5 mm, so obviously this part also will be 5 mm and this part also will be 5 mm, right? So this is also 5 mm. So therefore, what will be the length of the cylinder? Okay, if you take in the horizontal way, it is the length. If you take in the vertical way, that will become the height. So therefore, so here it is 5. So here, if you see this one, this complete diameter is 5, so radius will be 5 by 2 and this also is 5 by 2. That means this is 2.5, this is 2.5. 2.5 plus 2.5 is 5 and 14 minus 5 will give you 9. So this will be the length of the cylinder. That means length is nothing but height. Height of the cylinder is 9 mm. Here also we are having two cases, cylinder as well as hemisphere. So when you come across this part, cylinder as well as hemisphere part. So let us write the data for this, then we can go for the calculation. What is asked you to find out? Find the surface area of the capsule. To find out the surface area of the capsule, simple thing. Here what I am going to do, I have to take the CSA of cylinder plus CSA of two hemispheres. Okay. Here first is cylindrical part. When you are having here as cylinder and hemisphere, two hemispheres are there, obviously both are same, so we can calculate the hemisphere part and we can multiply with 2. So now cylindrical part, h is equal to 14 minus 5, this is 2.5, since the diameter is 5, so radius will be half of that, so this is 2.5 and 2.5, that is 5. So 14 minus 5 will give you 9. So 9 mm is the height of the cylinder. If you take horizontally, it is the length, and if you take vertically, it is the height. So h is equal to 9 and r is equal to, since the diameter is 5, so radius will be 5 by 2 mm. Okay, So now CSA of cylinder can be found out with the help of 2 pi RH. We have the parameters with us. Similarly, for the case of hemisphere, the same thing, diameter is 5 mm. Then obviously R is equal to 5 by 2 mm. So with the help of this CSA of the hemisphere can also be found out since we have R value. So we will take the CSA of cylinder and we will take the CSA of hemispheres. We will add them. That will give you the surface area of this complete capsule. Here we see. See CSA of cylindrical part 2 by RH. That is 2 into 22 by 7 into 5 by 2 into 9. That will be giving me as 990 by 7 mm square. CSA of two hemispheres. Okay. So 2 into 2 pi r square. That will be 4 pi r square. So 4 into 22 by 7 into 5 by 2 whole square. Which is nothing but 550 by 7 mm square. So total surface area of the capsule will be CSA of cylinder plus CSA of two hemispheres. That is 990 by 7 plus 550 by 7 mm square. That will be giving you as 220 millimeters, that is mm square, that is the complete area of the capsule. So this is what are the questions about. Thank you.